Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Goldie Crocker Wellness Center for today's scheduled contest between the Knights of Berkeley College and your NHTI Lynx. Today's game is being played under the rules of the USCAA, the YSCC, and the NCAA. Now for our visiting starting lineups. First, with the visitors from Berkeley College. Number one, Denise Maldonado Jones. Number 10, Trinity Sierra. Number 11, Denijah Jacobs. Number 13, Desiree Seeley. And number 20, Kaisie Villeneuve. The head coach of the Knights is Candace Derisi. And now for your NHTI Lynx. Number one, Emma Broadstone. Number two, Alexis Christensen. Number three, Janessa Lofton. Number four, Maggie Brown. And number 14, Bella Ferrazzani. The head coach of the Lynx is Jessica Hardiman and is assisted by John Tuttle. Now, will you please rise and remove your hats as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome. You're watching NHTI Lynx basketball. The Berkeley College Knights are in town, making the trip over from New York for this game. Tipping off the women's game right now. Men's game afterwards at 6 p.m. Winning the tip here is Berkeley College. And we are underway just like that. For all of us here at Lynx Athletics, my name is Berkeley Stevens. Thanks for tuning into this one. Berkeley College ranked in the top 10 in the nation in the USCAA coaches poll. At least their women's team, their men's team is unranked. NHTI's women's team is unranked in the coaches poll. Their men's team currently ranked at 6. Taking it up the court is Janissa Lofton. Short pass over to Alexis Christensen, and she drives through the lane down the paint. Loses the handle, and that one's stolen away. Cherokee Wheeler there on the steal, and in a fast break fashion, the Knights try and trudge up their court, but losing it in transition, and the Lynx have the ball back on their own baseline. Maggie Brown, pass down low. Knights take it away. Once again, fast break fashion, highway to the hoop. That one off the glass. Christensen gets the rebound. 1 minute gone by, no score. We played four quarters here, 10 minutes apiece. Zani goes for the reverse layup. That one doesn't find the mark. Driving down low, losing the handle, but the Knights keeping possession. That was Kanajic Jacobs. Liz will have the inbound play here right under the basket. Nice long inbound. This is a long two here off the back brick of the rim. Trinity Sierra gets the rebound, puts up the shot. That one's air ball, touches the baseline, and the Lynx get possession back. Christensen across half court, skips one over to Maggie Brown. She gets just inside the arc and pulls up a shot. That one's nicely blocked. That was Villanueva with the block for the Knights. And now in transition, here's Seeley. Her shot gets blocked. Nothing's coming easy this game. We've played 94 seconds, still scoreless. Desiree Seeley to inbound. Finds Villanueva at the top of the arc. Villanueva driving straight away. A little bit of window work there. Nice basket there by Villanueva. It's 2-0 Berkeley College. Here's Maggie Brown in response, trying to bank one off. That one doesn't find it. The Lynx to a nice offensive rebound, and they set up Brown for a shot from beyond the arc. No good there. Jacobs with some speed, bounce pass across the paint. Hard contact under the basket, no foul there. And the Knights deflect the Lynx pass up court, and the Lynx will keep possession. That'll be a travel if she came down, trying to jump through two Knight defenders. Jacobs passed off to the far side corner. Now it's Villanueva for three. Off the front of the rim, that one stays out. Jacobs gets the board and puts it back.
Seeley for two.
Pardon me, seems like that was Desiree Seeley with the putback bank shot. It's 4-0 Berkeley College. Another fast break coming up for the Knights. It's a tricky one though, and there's going to be a foul on the play. That's Janessa Lofton with the foul. And that'll send Seeley to the line. Seeley goes 1-for-2 from the line. She's got 3 total points, and the score is 5-0. Berkeley College leading over NHTI. Christensen has that one stolen away. Villanueva recovers. Pass up to Maldonado Jones, and the lay-in is easy. Maldonado Jones. Her first basket of the game. 7-0 Knights. Seeley Lofton, the three, splashed in that one, assisted by Maggie Brown. And the Lynx are on the board. That basket is now 7-3. Villanueva pulling up the shot over Maggie Brown. Sierra getting the rebound, puts up the bank, and that one's knocked out of bounds. Villanueva tried to follow the shot. Touched that one over the baseline. We've got a timeout here taken by Berkeley College.
Second timeout called for by Berkeley College.
Back and ready to go here after the Knights timeout. Bella Ferzani downs that one to Lofton, and the Knights are in the full court press. Lynx caught unawares by it. Maldonado Jones banks that one in. It's assisted by Villanueva. Long pass up the court finds Maggie Brown. She rifles one even farther down, and that one's picked off. The Knights nearly losing it here. Battle on the court floor, and it's a jump ball. This jump ball will benefit the Lynx. They'll hold on to possession here. 5 minutes, 50 seconds left in this first quarter. You can see what a mismatch out on the court. Kiese Villanueva is number 20 for the Knights. At 6'3", she towers over almost every player on every team she faces. That Nike Brown three off the mark. And now it's into the hands of the Knights again. Here's Jacobs driving. Has to kick that one out. Nearly lost the handle in the paint. Jacobs has it again. The corner three off the rim. That one stays out. Brown with the rebound. Pass up the court to Ferziani. Lynx lose it. Turn around, little hook shot there for Villanueva. She's now got four. It's 11-2 Knights. Lofton pulls up the three. It's tracking, and it's in.
Lofton for three.
Lofton's got six. All six for the Lynx. And they're still trailing by five. The Knights having 11. Villanueva, another three-pointer. That one rattles off the rim. Stays out. Broadstone does come away with the steal. Passes up the court to Maggie Brown. Looks like the Knights have backed off the press a little bit. Here's Christensen driving. No good there. Trinity Sierra gets the rebound. Christensen fights for it. It's a jump ball again. NHTI taking this 30-second timeout here, trying to get up a game plan. Trailing by five. It's the key to get back into this game. This one Coach Tuttle and Coach Hardiman are chatting about in their huddle. Berkeley College right now playing their game. They've got the bigs. They like to go down low with it, but not afraid to pull the trigger from beyond the arc. So far, the Knights don't have a three-pointer to their name. But they are dominating in the paint down low. Jordan Washington with it here straight away, driving down low, left-handed layup, no good. Villalba, the rebound. The follow-up chance didn't fall, and Rosani has it now. Whips one over the tall Villalba, finding Lofton, but it is stolen away. Washington gets the steal, passes along. Maldonado Jones will try and cross half-court with it. Lofton jumps into the play, nearly gets the steal. Washington recovers. No half-court violation there. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left here in the first quarter. Villanueva, the kick out, the three. Maldonado Jones couldn't sink it. Emma Blake with it, bounce pass up the court to Emma Broadstone. And the Lynx navigate their way through half-court. Maggie Brown to Frosiani. Rosani, no good on that shot. Sealy the three. Off the back of the rim. Trinity Sierra tried to rebound it. Knocked it over the baseline. Lynx ball. Like the referees changed possession on that out-of-bounds call. That's with it in here. Bounce pass to Sierra. No good. Maldonado Jones and Broadstone fighting for the board. And it is another Knights ball from the baseline. Christensen back into the game. Emma Blake gets a rest. Down pass successful, pump fake and a drive. Broadstone nearly stole it away. Going away with a pull up over everyone. Well, good, Lynx ball. Maggie Brown driving, nearly laid that one in over the top of Villanueva. Christensen. Three-pointer, no. Brown gets another rebound. Christensen floats one up. Once again, no, and it's knocked out, but it stays in possession of the Lynx. Cherokee Wheeler checks in for Trinity Sierra on the side of the Knights. Brown inbounds. Ferrazzani, the layup, no good. Difficult angle directly under the basket. Washington into the paint, driving. Looks like Broadstone got a piece of that on the block. The end of the play results in a foul. The Knights will head to the line to shoot two. Christensen was the one on the Lynx who committed the foul. At the line shooting two is Cherokee Wheeler. No points yet for Wheeler. She'll try and break the ice here. Knights are still leading 11-6. That free throw with a little bit of extra hang time. No good, 0-1. Wheeler's second also stays out. Broadstone reels it in untested, but the Knights are in the press. Rosani, long pass that got tipped, ended up finding Villanueva, and there's going to be a travel on this play. Inbound pass finds Brown at half court. She drops it back to Christensen, who gives it back up the court to Brown. Brown down low. Ferzani, the kick out. Christensen, the three ball. No good, reeling it into Seeley. A minute 40 left in the quarter. Seeley skips one across to Washington, and she lays it in. Jordan Washington's first bucket of the game. And it's now a 7-point lead for the Knights, 13-6. Brown the pass, down low. Ferrazzani, the mid-range jumper. That one doesn't fall. The Knights with the last touch, and the Lynx have it at the baseline. Quick shot off the inbound, no good. Washington reels in the rebound. Calm before the storm. Here is Washington. Surveys, screen gets set. And now Villanueva had some space to shoot. Passed over to Washington again. The contested shot with Brown right in her face. That one doesn't find the mark. Broadstone has it in the near side corner. Pass over to Christensen, and the Lynx succeed in the breakout. Maggie Brown down low across the paint. Rosani just lost control there, and the Knights have it back. Looked like some points were about to develop for NHTI. 30 seconds remaining here in the quarter. 15 on the shot clock for the Knights. Washington to skip pass. Feeling away with the three. Splashed in. She's got 7. Berkeley's 16. And the Knights now leading by 10. Washington in up play. Stepped out of bounds. And there's 14 seconds left in the quarter. Brown up the court. Ferrazzani, the pass over to Broadstone. Broadstone to Lofton for three. Back of the rim, it stays out. 3 seconds on the clock. And it looks like ball's out of bounds on the baseline. And it may remain in the Lynx's possession. And it looks like that is the call. Buzzer sounds after one, the score. Berkeley College Knights leading by 10 over NHTI, 16-6.
It's the Knights 16 and the Lynx 6.
We'll be back in just a minute with the second quarter of action. Back on the way here in the second quarter. Lynx possessing it. It's Lofton straight away. The pass over to Christensen. The Lynx right now chasing after 10 points. Brown driving. Floating one up. Nearly landed the hook shot. Ferrazzani gets it in the paint. A little bit of chaos ensuing. Down to the court floor we go. Brown recovers. It's the pass off. Foul called here. It looks like that one is going to be on Jacobs. And it is. Kanaja Jacobs' first foul of the game. And the layup of the clean steal up the court. Jacobs fouled on her layup attempt. She'll head to the line. No, we'll be at the baseline. Fouls on Emma Broadstone for NHTI. Inbound, Villanueva down low, makes the bank look easy as she just towers over everyone in the paint. Just like that, she's got 9 points. Brown wrestling for this one against Villanueva. And the Knights are rewarded with the jump ball. With it here, the pass over to Desiree Seeley. Seeley, who averages just over 6 points a game, drives down low, the floater. No good, but she will head to the line. Maggie Brown for the Lynx committed the foul there. Seeley's at the line shooting two. Had one trip to the line already this evening and went one for two. Seeley makes the first one. She's got 4 points. Knights back in that full court press. Christensen in some trouble, tried to pass that one up, and it's stolen away. Now the Knights slowing the offense back down. Driving baseline on the far side. Here's Wheeler, no good. Broadstone fighting for it. She gets the rebound. Brown's pass up to Christensen, stolen away. Jacobs, the layup, and it's good. Jacobs' first basket of the game. Pass up the court. Rosani dribbling here. Pass over to Christensen. The long two, no. Out of bounds it goes near the Knights sideline. Jacobs to Villanueva, three. Oh, Ferrazzani gets the rebound. Christensen driving, weaving through defenders, floating it in. Nice work. Lexi Christensen, her first basket of the game, is 21-8. Pass and a free drive down on the baseline. Olivia Sturgis breaks the ice. That's her first two of the game. 23-8. Nice leading. Still in that full court press. Still giving the Lynx trouble. Lopped in the pass to Broadstone, the layup, no. Foul called on the play, seems to be on the Knights. And it is. Jacobs picks up her second. Brown to inbound. Couldn't get it by the reach of Villanueva. Lofton inbounds, Ferrazzani with it, looking for a target, wanted to find Lofton. Villanueva reached out, grabbed it away, at half court she comes, passed over to Maldonado Jones, Jones driving, floating, no good. Christensen with it here. Christensen down low, skips one. Ferzani nearly lost control. Found a pass off. Back on the court floor for another jump ball. Christensen driving, banking, no good. Nearly found another bucket there. Now it's Maldonado Jones driving against Maggie Brown. Bumps into her and has to back off. Desiree Seely with it now. Passed over to Villanueva with three. Back on the rim, no good. Ferzani with it, up to Lofton. Lofted across half court. Cherokee Wheeler jumps in. Looks like she picked up a reaching foul as well. And she did, her first foul of the game. Back into the game for the Lynx is Emma Blake. Lofton finds Ferzani down low. She's fouled on her way up and she'll head to the line. Maldonado Jones picks up her first foul. Ferrozani's at the line to shoot two. Knocks down the first one. The Lynx have played one game since winter break. Ferrozani is a new player transferring in. Fortunately, stats weren't uploaded from that first game, so as far as I know, these are her first 2 points with NHTI. We're not sure, but they are her first points here at the Paul Hogan Court on NHTI's campus. That is for certain. Pass down low, Villanueva almost unfairly reaches up to get it. Nearly knocked down the basket for the three-point play. Instead, she'll just head to the line to shoot two. That foul committed by Emma Blake.
At the line, Berkeley
College. This is Villanueva's first trip to the line here. She's got 9 points. Game high amongst all players. 0 for 1 on free throws so far. She'll try and enter double-figure territory with this one. And that one doesn't fall either, so she stays at 9 points. Maldonado Jones gets the rebound. Once again, it's a jump ball. Villanueva leading the Berkeley College Knights in all scoring. She averages 19.4 points per game. Pretty understandable why. Now she's the centerpiece of the team. The Knights actually lost Kaya Hugh, who was the previous team leader in scoring. Not sure what happened to Hugh, but she's no longer on the roster, which makes Villanueva the queen of the team. I would expect that point per game average to go skyrocketing up in the second half of the season for her. Nice inbound. Villanueva reaches up for it. Goes to work on Maggie Brown down low. Looks like there's a foul on the play, and it might be on Maggie. And it is.
Her second.
Brown's second foul. As you may have heard, Villanueva's back at the line again. 0 for 2 on that recent trip. Still sitting at 9 points. Makes the first one. She's the first player this evening with double-digit points. She's got 10. Emma Blake gets the rebound on the second free throw. Finds Ferrozani. Knight's still in that full-court press. Tough to navigate behind the back dribble. The Lynx staying away from the ball. The Lynx forced to call a timeout. Unable to get across half court in time.
Timeout taken by NHTI. Third or second timeout. second. At the line, Berkeley College, number 10, Trinity Sierra, shooting two.
Throw gets made by Carazana. She's 3 for 3 from the stripe tonight. Oh, that's Lofton, pardon me. Now it's Carazana at the line. Lofton went 1 for 2. She's got a total of 7 points. Carazana is shooting 2 here. This one kicks out off the front. 5 minutes, 20 seconds left here in the first half. Berkeley College leading 24-11. Arizona's second, nothing but net. She's got 3 points on the day. Desiree Seely here setting up the offense straight away. Nice screen set by Sierra. Seely's going to the line. Looks like Arizona picked up a foul. Yes, she did. Short, a little bit to the right of the target. This is her third trip to the line already tonight. She was 0 for 2 on those. She's 2 for 6 from the free throw line. See the pass up to Berzani. Berzani pulls the trigger from 3. Nothing but that for Berzani. She's got 6 points. 24-15 as Ferzani chisels away at that deficit. Here's the Knights in response. Sturgis down low, lays it in. Tough layup made by Olivia Sturgis. And it's 26-15. Rodstone with it. Bullet pass across the court to Brown. Brown pulls the trigger off the back of the rim. Rodstone follows up. No good on the second chance. Trinity Sierra feels it. Seely again between the leg dribble, has some space to shoot, goes over Broadstone, the long two-pointer, no good. And it's a Lynx ball, that one last touching off here in Riva. Inbound pass on the baseline, nearly stolen away, but Broadstone has it, going by Seely, so pass over to Lofton. Boston dribbles it. Short pass over to Maggie Brown. Gets it back. Boston from the far corner. Off the front of the rim. Broadstone trying to rebound, but Sturgis gets it. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left in the first half. Here's Seeley with it again. The pass over to Maldonado Jones. And she traveled on that move. Just by the free throw line. With a nice steal there, intercepting that pass. Seeley slows it down. Straight away, guarded by Ferrazzani. Seeley goes for it. It's the hoop and the horn. She'll head to the line. Out. Just a two-point play there for Seeley. She averages 6.3 points per game. Currently sitting at six. Sparazzani, another three from the same spot. Splashed in. Sparazzani starting to heat up. She's got 9 points. Lynx still trailing by 10. It's 28-18. Here's Seeley with some space, pulls the shot, long jumper, going away, but gets the rebound, puts it back home for two. Rodstone, the long jumper, left that one short. Ferrazzani gets the rebound, deals around with it, passed over to Maggie Brown. They get it back up top, pushes it over the Lofton. Lofton moves it to her right. Broadstone sets a nice screen. The pass off to Christensen. She pulls the trigger. Front of the rim and it stays out. Maldonado Jones, the rebound. Trinity Sierra down low, banked in for two. That one assisted by the Arabian. Those were Sierra's first points of the game. Now the Lynx in response. This is a long two from Broadstone. No good. Sturgis gets it. Sturgis to Seeley. She'll break out as the Lynx let off the press. Seeley moves to her right. Guarded by Brown. The pass over the head of Brown to Villanueva. Turnaround jumper. Splashed in. Villanueva with 14. Leading the charge for these Knights. Maggie Brown really had to stole it away, run into trouble. No travel called on that play. Maldonado Jones has it here, driving against two Lynx defenders. Button hooks and turns back to her right. Seeley has it now. Sturgis handles the pass, a minute 20 seconds left in the half. Sturgis spinning, jump shot, left short. In the pass across the paint. Ferrazzani couldn't lay it in. Followed her shot, got a rebound, turnaround jumper. That one good to go. Ferrazzani got 11, leading the way for the Lynx. It's 34-20. Under a minute left here in the first half. Maldonado Jones steps inside the arc. Passed over to Seeley now. Seeley over the head of Broadstone, down to Villanueva. Turnaround jumper. Inside the paint, Brown nearly got the rebound. Villanueva fighting on the floor for it against Christensen. From her knee, she pulls up the shot. Brown gets the rebound. 35 seconds left in the half. The pass up to Christensen. She skips it across to Broadstone. Broadstone from a sharp angle to turn around. No. Now there's 24 seconds left in the half. Seeley gets it. Brown guarded. No foul on the play. Brown gets it up the court to Broadstone. 10 seconds in the half. Ferrazzani the three. Front of the rim, it stays out. Seeley handles it. Five on the clock. Maybe one final shot. No. Interception, defensive collection. And that sounds the horn for the first half. Berkeley College Knights leading 30-20. To the NHTI Lynx. We'll be back for 10 minutes. Start the second half. All right, and we're back, about to start the second half of action here between the Knights of Berkeley College and the Lynx of NHTI. Knights currently leading 34-20 over the Lynx. Sorry if we left you with a black screen there during halftime. Like something was laying down on a button that changed the cameras to a camera we don't have today. But we're back, so we're ready to get going here. Leading the game in scoring so far is Casey Villanueva. She's got 14 points, averages just under 20 per game. And then on the side of the Lynx, Bella Ferrazzani, she's got 11 points. Rodstone pulls up for the first shot of the game, no good. Villanueva gets the rebound. The Knights come up the court with it. Anaja Jacobs here, straight away, defended by Rodstone. Villanueva sets a screen, but not going to be used. Driving down through the lane, not able to make the layup though. It was a nice drive. She weaved her way through perfectly. The finish just wasn't there. Definitely make sure you stay tuned too. If the next game interests you, the men's teams are playing. Incredibly good teams this year at the USCAA. NHTI is ranked 6th in the nation in the most recent coaches poll. At one point a few weeks ago, they were ranked number 1. Suffered a loss to UMaine 4-10, and then Vermont State University, and that bumped them down to 6th. But the Lynx still capable of beating any team in the USCAA, as I'm sure they'll prove as we continue to move on through this season. Berkeley College's men's team is not yet, but I'm sure they're good enough to be nationally ranked. It's just a matter of time. You've got to play the right opponents for those wins to show up and prove themselves. NHTI had a really difficult schedule at the start of the season, which helped them get that ranking. Austin's at the line, shooting these technical foul free throws. The tech was on Kanija Jacobs, number 11 on the Knights. Austin goes 1-for-2 from the line in that trip. She's got 8 of NHTI's 21. Finds Villanueva. Can't bank that one in. Broadstone gets it. Contact on the play when she passed that one up to Verrazzani. Verrazzani skips one over to Lofton. She can't finish the layup. Now it's the Knights sprinting down the court. Jacobs not able to lay that one. Again, fast break fashion. Here's Lofton. She passes over to Maggie Brown. Drives through the lane. Hard contact on that play as Brown goes down. The Lynx will keep possession. Into the game for the first time, Zaniah Henderson. Brown inbounds. Gets it right back. The long jumper from the corner. No good. Ferrazzani gets the rebound blocked away. Villanueva with solid connection on the pumpkin there, swatting that one out of bounds. Lynx will reset here from the baseline. Brown inbounds. Going away with swats that one also. Brown hunting for a target, finds Broadstone on the far side. turns on. He's got it. Verzani with a nice move gets inside the paint. The kick out. Brown the three. And it's in. Lynx back to within 10. It's 24. It's Maggie Brown's first basket of the game, and it's a big one. Nice three-pointer drain. Going away the travels here. Wanted to stutter step, just didn't time it right. Berkeley College is going to be taking a full timeout here.
Full timeout called for by Berkeley College.
Nice start to this second half by NHTI. Putting up a fight against the nationally ranked Berkeley College. Not an easy thing to do. Hanging in there. Philip Arizani, player here for the Lynx. Didn't play at all the first half of the season prior to winter break in that first semester, but since transferred to join the team, and now she's playing with 11 points for NHTI. Hot on her tail is Janessa Lofton, chasing after the 1,000-point milestone this season in her senior season. Right now she's got 8 points. I believe that puts her at 84 total on the season. She needs just over 200 to break the 1,000-point mark. Right now, she's on pace. Has to average 11 points per game to hit that mark. Rosani bounces one to Lofton, who heads down with a ton of speed. She's fouled on that difficult layup, just putting pressure on the Knights down low. Lofton smiling all the way to the stripe as she'll take two free throws here.
Fouled by Berkeley College, number 13 ceiling. Alina NHTI, number 3 Lofton.
Lofton sinks the first. Lock in 2 for 2, and she's got 10 points. Villanueva, the deep ball, no good. Rattles off the rim, Lofton reels it in. Now Lofton up the court, Lynn takes a spin, little button hook back, and Christensen launches the three, but straight away, Ferzotti fights and gets the rebound. Villanueva gets a hand on it as she tries to get back up with the shot. And the Knights recover possession. Henderson down low, jumping in. Jump ball called. Lucky break there for Henderson, as to me it looked like that foot came down before there was a tie-up. I would have called it a travel. But I'm also not who you want reffing a basketball game. Maggie Brown draws out a nice foul there before the inbound play. The Lynx have the ball back. That's Villanueva's first foul of the game. The Knights still in this full court press, making things so difficult for NHTI. Lofton's under some trouble, has to just rifle that one overhand up the court. Finds Broadstone successfully. She gives it off to Brown down low. And it's it. Nice ball move on the front of the Lynx. Zani has got 13 points. That one assisted by Brown. Total team play there for the Lynx. I think that's the best looking play they've had all night. Escaping that full court press that's caused so much trouble. And having every player get a touch on it before the layup down low unguarded by Ferrazzani. On the other end of the court, Broadstone picks up her third foul of the game. And the Knights will inbound right under the hoop. Way up, down low, going to Weva. Makes another one look easy. She's got 16. Lofton. One over, Ferrazzani, Christensen, the kick out to the corner, Broadstone moves to her left, nice dribble, gets it to Lofton, Now Brown open for a three, and it's in. And the Lynx are heating up. They're back to within five. Maggie Brown sinks the three, assisted by Lofton. And it's 36-31. Maldonado Jones driving, banking. Nice bit of window work there. Maldonado Jones with 6 points. Carrizzani on the other end. The layup no good. But she will head to the line. Blocking foul there on Trinity Sierra. That's her first. Carrizzani heads back to the free throw line. Tonight, Carrizzani's 3-for-4. First one finds it. Carrizzani's got 14 points. And make it 15. 33-38. NHTI still trailing. Back to within five. Nice move on her way in. And the layup is good as Sealy. Number two to go. Off it. It's up to Brown. Brown now across Broadstone. The turnaround jumper, no good. Follows the shot. Gets it back. Gets it back again. Broadstone will go to the floor with it. There's another jump ball. Attempted, that one missed. Tommy gets the rebound. Here come the Lynx. Brown with it now. The Knights fully backed off the press. Brown makes her way in. Tries to go over, throwing away, but that one's blocked. But Christensen has it back. Christensen. Now to Brown. Brown drives again. Hook shot blocked again. Throwing away, but not letting anything by. Seven on the shot clock. Brown with the ball. Now Lofton. Five to shoot. Gets off the shot off the back of the rim. Kicks out into the hands of Henderson. Henderson trying to do it herself. No, the kick out to Maldonado Jones. The jumper no good. Rebounding is Christensen. She'll bounce it across to Lofton. The Lynx make their way up the court again. Lofton slows it down. Passes to her left. Christensen with an open look from three. No good. Rebounding is Wheeler. The Knights still leading here. 4 minutes, 10 seconds left in the third quarter. I believe we've got a foul called here on the Knights again. This one looks to be on Sealy. The Knights already with two technical fouls to their name, both for unsportsmanlike. That's Sealy's second foul. No tech on that one. NHTI will take a full timeout before these free throws coming up. They're still trailing by seven. Just over 4 minutes to play in the third quarter. It's been an awfully good second half of basketball. If you're a Lynx fan, they were trailing big at halftime, and now they're within striking distance. last foul before the timeout was the fifth foul for Berkeley College this quarter. So NHTI is in the bonus. They're shooting two from the line here. It's Bella Ferrozani. She's got 15 points right now.
NHTI
outscoring the Knights strongly here in this quarter. Ferrozani knocks down another. Score at halftime was 34-20 in favor of Berkeley. And now it's 40-34. The Knights only with 6 points so far in this quarter, and NHTI have put up 14. They don't seem to be done yet. Driving right now is Henderson. That one's stolen away. Berkeley College, though, getting it right back. Jumping into the play as Ferrozani tried to transition down. Ferrozani went down to the floor. Banged her knee hard off the court floor, too. Ferrozani needs some pain, but seems like she'll be all right. Weva gets a little freebie down low. She's got 18 points. One under her average of 19 per game. Maggie Brown with it. Whistles one inside. Ferrozani, the hook shot. It's all Henderson defending. Ferrozani's got 18 points. Tied for the game high. We're doing a Weva on the side of the Knights. Now in response, it's Henderson. She bags one in. That's her first basket of the game. 44-36. Knights back to leading by eight. Here's Brown from bonus distance. No good. Ferrozani gets the board. And the quick point. Ferrozani, the first player to 20. What a game she's having. 44-38. Under 3 minutes left in the quarter. NHTI are certainly back to within range of winning this game. Going away this three was off the mark there. Ferrozani gets the board. Ferrozani's got lost it across the court on the right. She'll see Maggie Brown right behind her. And Brown to Christensen, who fires the two. No. Wheeler handles that one. Long pass up the court. Villanueva. She's got 20. Lofton with a move across half court. Gets inside to the free throw line. And knocks down the jumper. Nice stop by Lofton. She's got 12. 46-40. Over at the Knights. 2 minutes left in the corner. Everyone on the bleachers. Totally tuned to this one. Henderson driving, and it's going to be a Lynx ball for the third baseline. Checking back into the game for the Knights. Desiree Seale, she's had a nice game herself. She's got 9 points in this one. Lofton across half court, gets a double screen at the feed to Ferrozani. And she knocks down another jumper. Ferrozani with 22 of NHTI's 42 points. Now Seeley with a move inside. Seeley with 11 points now. Aggie Brown, the deep ball from straight away, though. Front of the rim into the hands of Seeley. Seeley weaves her way through two defenders across half court, gets the pass up to Villanueva, who's fouled by Lofton. But Villanueva unable to make the layup. That's only Lofton's second foul.
Foul by NHTI.
Pretty good player two foul so far, at least right now. Villanueva's only 1-for-4 from the line. She makes the first one, 2-for-5 from the stripe so far. Violation on the shooter, second one doesn't count even if it went. Going away, but still got 21 points. And the Berkeley College Knights still lead 49-42. Lofton, the feed, over to Broadstone. Broadstone turns inside, goes for a difficult layup. Fired that one off the bottom of the backboard. Seeley comes up with it. Down the court she comes. Christensen inside, defense. No foul on the play. Excellent defense by Christensen. But the Knights keep possession. Emma Blake back into the game for Christensen. Gets a well-deserved rest after that last play. Seeley to inbound, finds Villanueva. She turns around, the jumper in the paint, no good. Sturgis follows it up with a second chance, no. Lofton gets a steal after Sturgis got her own rebound. Lofton had to pull up, stop the handle. Able to feed Maggie Brown. 35 seconds left on the clock in the quarter. Emma Blake down low, off the glass. Blake's first basket, a big one. The Lynx back to within five. It's 49-34. Henderson with it. 19 seconds left. Maybe one final possession in the quarter. Going away with his three-pointer off the mark on the left side. Broadstone fights for it. Brown gets it. And they call it a kick ball. Taking away the chance from Brown. They call the kick ball on Broadstone. Broadstone nodding her head to her coach. Definitely booted that one up to Brown. Almost got away with it, too. Another reason why you don't want me officiating. Oh, Seeley travels off the inbound play. So the Lynx have it back. There's only 5.4 seconds left on the clock, but the Lynx could steal a ton of momentum in this game with a final basket to beat the buzzer in the third quarter. Lofton across half court, 2 seconds to shoot. Lofton jumps, banks, no good. After three quarters, we're awfully close now. 44-49 with the Knights out in front. We'll be back in a minute. Quarter of action, stay tuned. 44. Your seat, as this one's gotten awfully interesting here in the third quarter. Folks, about to start the fourth quarter here. I'm going to step away for just the first couple minutes of this one, do the second part of my job as the SID here at NHTI. I'm going to take some photos just to start this quarter. I'm going to hop back on the mic in just a few, but right now the score is 49, Berkeley College, 44, NHTI, if you want to keep track at home in my absence for the next couple minutes. Thank you.
held by Berkeley College, number 11, Jacobs. Her fourth.
Back, scores 56, Berkeley College, 48, NHTI. throw. The Wave has got 28 points after that free throw. Here's Lofton for a three. No good there. Off the back glass and out into the hands of Trinity Sierra. Lofton right now is 12 points. Maggie Brown recently went down on a play. Seems like we'll see her again. Just took some contact to the face. Has to have a brief rest. Hopefully we see her back in this one. It's awfully close here. Ferrazzani's leading the way for the Lynx. She pulls the trigger. The three is good. Ferrazzani, 25 points. Lynx back to within five. It's 56-51. Henderson has that one stolen away. Christensen gets the swat. Lofton ends up with the pickup. Here's Broadstone challenging down low, driving through the block, laying it in with the left. That's Broadstone's first basket of the game, looking like it's scoring naturally. Points back to within a basket against the nationally ranked Berkeley College team. It's 56-53. What a showing the Lynx have put on here in the second half. At halftime, they were trailing by 14, 34-20. And they outscored Berkeley College 24-15 in the third quarter to get back to within five. Now they're back to within three.
The line Henderson shooting good.
Zaniah Henderson, this is the first of two free throws. Janessa Lofton was the Lynx who picked up the foul. It's her third of the game. Maggie Brown back into the game for NHTI. Henderson, after missing the first, misses the second, and it stays just a one-basket game. The Lynx could tie it up here with a three. Christensen, though, driving the three lane, and she'll take two to go. Christensen's got a total of 4 points, and it's a one-point game here in Concord. Pass down low to Trinity Sierra. Loses the handle. Ferrazzani gets the steal, and the Lynx have possession. 5 minutes remain in this one. It's a one-point game. Lofton, Christensen, the three, block. That's the sixth block of the game by Villanueva. She's already got a double-double. Here's Henderson, weaving her way through, laying it in. No, but Villanueva gets the rebound, and the second chance is good. Villanueva's broken 30 points now. NHTI call a 30-second timeout. They've got one full timeout left. Still a one-basket game after the Villanueva bank shot there. It's 58-55. Berkeley College is out in front. The Lynx have not had a lead tonight. But anything is possible in this game. Underway here, 4.5 minutes left in this one. Maggie Brown down low, Ferrazzani couldn't handle the pass, lost speed on it, and stolen away by the Knights. Their pass down to Villanueva puts her just dangling over the baseline, but she keeps it in bounds. Nyjah Jacobs now slows down the offense. 15 on the shot clock, she makes a move inside. Definitely traveled on her way through the paint that time. Nice defensive stop there by the Lynx, clogging the lane, getting the ball back. 4:05 left on the clock. Brown surveying, making her move, Villanueva guarding her. Another block for Villanueva. I believe that's her sixth of the game. Seventh of the game for Villanueva. She's working on a triple-double if she gets three more. Maggie Brown inbounding here under the basket. Finds Lofton. Lofton sets the offense up. Only 8 seconds to shoot. Lofton pulls the trigger. No good. Throwing away the chase with the rebound and gets it easily. basket. Passed up to Jacobs, and Jacobs bounces one across. Can't connect with Seely. It's out of bounds, but it is a Knights ball. ...58-55 if you're just tuning in. Berkeley College leading. Here's Villanueva down low, and she makes it a five-point game. Villanueva's got 32 of Berkeley College's 60 points. And they've got a five-point lead over NHTI. Lofton has the screen set by Brown. Gets it to Brown, who drives against Villanueva. No contact on that one. No block for Villanueva. But the Knights do come away with it. Jump ball called. It'll be NHTI's possession. Lofton inbounds, finds Ferrazzani. Ferrazzani from the near side corner, dribbles behind her spine. She's hurt her ankle on this play. She goes down to the floor. Cherokee Wheeler checks on her. Hopefully she's okay. She's got 25 points for the Lynx. It's a shame to see her go down right now as the trainers come out. Ferrazzani on her feet, makes her way off the court under her own accord. It's a great sign here for NHTI. Hopefully she's back and able to play within the final 3 minutes of this one. Still a five-point game. Corner splashed in. Seely's got 14 points after that one. That's her first corner of the game. It's 63-55 for the College out in front. Maggie Brown with the ball, pass over to Lofton. Lofton gives it back. 10 seconds to shoot here for the Lynx. Christensen driving, nearly lost the handle, lays it up. And they're going to call it travel here. Knights with the ball back. Back into the game, Ferrazzani. It's good to see her back after hurting that ankle on a previous play. Bounced back within 40 seconds of game time. Nice move inside. Kanaja Jacobs lays that one in. She's got 4 points. It's 65-55. Berkeley College building some momentum. Lofton with a three, and it's good. Lofton with 15 points. 2 minutes to play. Lynx trailing by seven. Another move inside, and we're going to call that a travel, absolutely. Another technical foul has been dished out. I believe this one's on Jacobs. Lofton's taking the free throws again for the Lynx. That's the third technical of the game for the Knights. The referees have had no tolerance or any of it since the first quarter as Lofton makes the first one. And shocked to see the Knights players continue to just plead their case, whatever way it may be. Lofton makes fourth at the technical free throw. She's got 17 points, and it's back to a five-point game. Maggie Brown daps her up at half court as the Lynx are smiling through this one. Up the court come the Lynx after those technical foul free throws. 1:40 on the clock with Lofton driving inside. She'll backpedal. Christensen now over to Maggie Brown. Christensen moves down to the paint. Brown goes to the other side. Her layup blocked by Villanueva. Remain a Lynx ball here just under the basket. Christensen down low has that one swatted by Sturgis. Sturgis reels it in as well. 80 seconds left in this five-point game. Desiree Seely fires one down to Trinity Sierra. Maggie Brown called for a foul. You could hear her hand hit the ball on the block. That's crazy.
Ball by the Lynx. Brown at the line. Berkeley College. Number 10, Trinity Sierra. That's Brown's fifth foul of the game.
That's the fifth and final foul from Maggie Brown. She is out. 75 seconds left in this game. Another technical on the side of Berkeley College. Are you kidding me? This happened a lot last year when they came to our court. If they got three techs in that last time. I'm going to go online right now and double check that. Because the last time they were in this building, it was a very similar, very messy game. Hoffman's taking the free throws again. She's made five straight free throws. Make it six. She's feeling it. 18 points right now for Lofton. Makes them both. Back to a one-basket game. Last time the Knights played the Lynx here in Concord, the Lynx won 82-77. And Berkeley College did get three technicals last year when they played. Trinity Sierra on the other end. She makes the first. Second one doesn't fall for her. It is a four-point game. 70 seconds left as Lofton carries it across half court. Fires the three. Off the backboard it goes. Sierra gets the rebound. Berkeley College call a timeout.
I was
reading out from the men's stats last year for the Berkeley College NHTI game. The women's game, the last time Berkeley College was here, Berkeley College won 63-52. There were no technicals in the women's game. It was all from the men's game. My memory betrayed me. But it was quite a loud affair the last time Berkeley College was here. Both games, men's and women's, were fantastic last year. This one kicking off this evening between these women's teams has been excellent. 66 seconds remain. Berkeley College has 66 points. NHTI trailing by four. They've got 62. Desiree Seely with it here. Passes lofting one inside. Filling away the banks at high off the glass. She's got 34 points. It's back to a six-point game. Lofton pass over. Farazana. She ranges over, gliding to the left, finding Lofton with a pass back. Lofton to Ferrazzani again, 15 to shoot. Inside, now Broadstone with the kickout shot. Sturges with the rebound. Lofton fights for the steal. Villanueva comes up with it. 25 seconds left. It's a six-point game with the clock ticking down. No shot clock left. Henderson's got it. She'll turn. Berkeley College slowing things down. Berkeley winding down the clock. Kill the game here. Leading by six. Broadstone picks up the desperation foul in the final 10 seconds. Ten seconds and 6 points. And now five. NHTI not able to get the quick steal. Sealy winding down the clock. 2 seconds and one. Final buzzer sounds. And the Knights emerge victorious. In an awfully close game where the Knights were once leading by 14 at halftime, NHTI make it interesting. They fall 68-62. For all of us here, it's athletics. My name is Martin Stevens. Joining us for this game, we've got the men's tip-off. 15 minutes at 6 p.m. Come back for that broadcast. I'll see you soon.